Why do antidepressants kill your sex drive? That's what I'm going to be talking about today. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I publish weekly videos on mental health education and self-improvement. If you don't want to miss a video, click subscribe and notifications. The medications that we use to treat depression can be divided into two categories, the ones that enhance serotonin and the ones that don't. The only one that doesn't, though, is bupropion, also known by the brand name Wellbutrin. Serotonin is a neurotransmitter or nerve chemical that plays a role in regulating your mood, but it also affects other nerves that control other parts of your body. So, for example, we actually have more serotonin receptors in our gut than we do in our brain. And that's why nausea is a very common side effect with these medications. Unfortunately, high serotonin levels in your brain interfere with your sexual behavior. And the sexual dysfunction that you can get is things like having little or no sexual interest, delayed climax or inability to have an orgasm at all, erectile dysfunction, and decreased sensation in your genital area. Some studies have shown that this can happen as frequently as 60 to 70%, and that's a lot of people affected. The positive news is that this is often dose dependent. So that means that the higher you go up on the drug, the greater the chance that the symptoms will crop up. Then if you lower the dose, the problem can go away. And as long as your depression or anxiety doesn't come back with that lower dose, then that can be a good working solution for you. Also, in about 10 to 20% of people, the symptoms go away if you watch and wait and don't do anything or change the dose. What are some workarounds to this problem? As it turns out, dopamine, another neurotransmitter, enhances sexual activity, especially sexual interest. Wellbutrin is an antidepressant that increases dopamine and norepinephrine. So if you have depression but you don't have much anxiety, taking Wellbutrin as your antidepressant can eliminate this problem. But if you do need to take a serotonin agent, sometimes adding Wellbutrin can reverse the sexual side effects of your Lexapro or whatever serotonin agent that you're taking. This is not a change that you can make yourself, but you can raise this issue with your doctor and see if he or she thinks that it'd be a good solution for you. If the Wellbutrin addition doesn't work for you, or you can't take Wellbutrin for some reason, then what do you do? Sometimes adding a medication like BUSPAR can help. BUSPAR is for anxiety, and the reason that it helps is complicated, but suffice it to say that it activates a receptor that can offset this problem. Two more possibilities or two more solutions are CYPROHEPTADINE, also called periactin, is an antihistamine that is often used to treat nausea, but it also has some serotonin blocking properties. One of the downsides, though, is that it can be sedating, and this may not work so well if you're trying to take it as a pre-sex preparation. The herb GINKGO biloba increases blood flow to the genital organs, and so that may help with arousal. But as with most over-the-counter remedies, the results of this can be hit or miss. Now, if it happens with one antidepressant, it's not a given or an automatic that it's going to happen with another one. So a last solution could be to try a different antidepressant. But this depends on whether it's worth it to you to start over with something else. And you are at risk of having your depression or your anxiety return if you switch to another drug that's not as effective in treating your depression. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Like the video if you like it and leave me a comment or just say hi to me. Thanks for watching.